Hey everybody, it's Triple L, and by Odin's beard, am I excited to talk to you guys about this topic. Hero Academia Season 3, Episode 2. It was a pretty interesting episode, and guys, do stay tuned. I will have a bigger video for that, just the impression video and all that. But this had a bigger thing. There was a scene unleashed in this episode that, as far as I am aware, does not happen in the manga, most likely anywhere, because it's definitely not happening in the sequence of events it should be. It's not in the manga, it's an anime original scene, and it has giant implications for one aspect of the fandom. That's specifically the traitor theory. The people who are sitting down to try and figure out if there's a traitor and who the traitor is, this scene has a giant impact on that whole base. So let's play it through real quick right here. Here you go.
さすが先生だ。 どんなに調べても分からなかった奴らの目的地を。
This scene is so ridiculously critical. And man, anime onlys, congrats to you guys. You guys get to have a very unique experience compared to the manga readers. Because the flow of events here, they would change how people think about who the traitor could be if there actually is a traitor. So anime onlys, let's just be clear, like there's gonna be some spoilers here, but like listen, if you watch the second episode of this season, if you've seen the opening, you know villains are gonna get involved somehow in the first 12 episodes of season 3. I'm gonna try to be careful with spoilers, but it's gonna happen given the material we're talking about. But again, this is all coming with the idea of people theorizing for traitors, and that in and of itself, a theory isn't really a spoiler. So anyway, going into this, the critical line here is where Shigaraki goes and tells Black Mist, "I expect nothing less from Master, finding so easily the destination of those guys that I couldn't find, no matter how hard I looked." This line does not occur in the manga, but it is so critical because of when this is happening. So here's the thing. The majority of the traitor theories, one of the core aspects of evidence or rationales that people use in it when it comes to the traitors is that if this traitor is a student, the student would have been giving information away in real time from the destination. The students have cell phones. The idea would be that the students sent their coordinates after they had reached their destination. What this new scene gives us, however, is that the destination was leaked before any of the students even got to the place that they were going. This is giant because it shifts the focus away from the students, or at least it ridiculously reduces the odds when it comes to the students and reorients it back to the teacher faculty. So when it comes to the popular traitor theories among students, the Ochoko theory, the Kaminari theory, the Toru theory, all those involve the students being at the location or require the students to be at the location to know where they are to be able to send coordinates. That rationale is effectively destroyed by this scene. Because now it's turning it into a case of All For One has the connections. All For One used the connections to get the destination of where those kids were going, and All For One also was able to circumvent the security precautions that the heroes had in place to ensure that no one could follow them. All For One did that, and that's not even saying whether or not All For One has an extrasensory type quirk that can just give him information like this. If you're the kind of person who wants to argue that it's a student, now you have to answer the question, how did the student know where they were going ahead of time, ahead of them actually being there? Do they have some kind of special skill that can allow them to take that information from the teachers without getting detected? I don't know. This is pretty cool. This one scene changed the tone for the upcoming episodes compared to what the manga readers initially got. And this one scene dismantles, or at least puts a dent in a lot of the traitor theories that revolve around the students. And now with this, like again, it is definitely shifting the focus over back into the faculty, because hey, the chances that the students would know this information, pretty slim. Chances that the faculty know this information, pretty high comparatively. So guys, that's where I'm gonna leave you. What do you think? This is a giant wrench in the gears. All For One got the information for Shigaraki, and now they are able to mobilize their troops. So guys, what do you think? Who's your traitor right now, given this information? Let me know down below. Like honestly, right now, my most crack theory traitor that I'm like deciding to put forward for this? Vlad, the class 1B homeroom teacher right now, he's not looking so good in my eyes. But guys, let me know what you think down below. Gonna call it there, very short video, but stay tuned for the Hero Academia impression video and Darling in the Franxx as well if you're a fan of that. But till next time, have a great day. I hope I get this out before other people.